the name of the game.
Mesdames et messieurs, Monsieur le Président de la République.
Look at that. He sits down on that throne as if he liked it.
After all, Louis Napoleon's a Bonaparte. Emperors seem to run in his family.
Mm-hmm. As a staunch believer in the Republic, that's exactly why I'm worried.
You better keep your mind on the game.
Third and deciding set. Monsieur de Lesset will serve.
Who's that playing against de la Tour?
Ferdinand de Lesset, Monsieur le President, son of our Consul General to Egypt.
Oh, yes, he's in the Foreign Office, isn't he?
One of our most promising young diplomats.
Debray.
Who's that? Countess Eugenia Montijo from Madrid.
She's very enthusiastic about the game.
Especially when young de Lesseps is playing.
The young man has a keen eye for other things than a tennis ball. See that Monsieur de Lesseps is invited to my next reception.
Yes, Monsieur le President.
And of course, Countess. What's her name, too?
Yes, Monsieur le President.
The court at Stein. Prior von Adlon, Baron Bryson. Monsieur Franz Liszt.
Ah, Monsieur Liszt. I shall have the pleasure of asking you to play with us this evening.
It will be my honor to hear the president.
Let me hear.
Ferdinand, you mustn't in front of all these people.
It's your fault for living so beautiful.
Now, look here, if you don't stop, I won't have any reflection left at all.
Why, have you already shocked half Paris by riding astride?
Oh, that's different.
Oh, yes, I know you look very charming and breeched.
Thank you.
How is it?
Oh, Ferdinand, there's a fortune teller.
And before the year is out, you will be married for the fourth time.
Good evening, Eugenie. Isn't it marvelous? My fourth marriage. I only just lost my second husband. Louis, dear, your parties are so different. Only you would think of having a fortune teller.
I'm glad you're enjoying yourself, Duchess.
Oh, you haven't been presented. Let me. The Countess Eugenie de Montijo. Monsieur le President. Monsieur le President.
I had heard that the Countess de Montijo was one of the most beautiful women in Paris.
Oh, really?
For once, the gossips didn't exaggerate.
And this is Monsieur de Lesseps.
I have always had a great respect for your father. I'm happy to be his son.
Monsieur le President is very kind.
May I have the pleasure of this waltz?
Oh, why, yes, of course. Would you excuse us?
Monsieur le President, the British ambassador has just arrived.
Oh, yes. Duty has no manners. It is always intruding. You forgive me?
Of course I understand.
May I hope for another dance?
With pleasure. Monsieur René, good evening. How are you?
Good evening, Eugenie.
Well, the most beautiful woman not only in Paris, but in the entire world. Honor me with this next dance.
Let's have our fortune told him, Sarah.
He doesn't need his fortune told.
Oh? Oh.
He's already predicted the most brilliant future for himself.
Oh, but what about my future?
That's easy. We're going to share mine.
Well, we'll see what the Swami has to say about that.
Sahib, Mama Sahib.
We'd like one of your very best fortunes for the young lady.
One of your very best ones now, please.
The sand falls slowly. I see difficulties. Yes, I see a troubled life, but a great one. You will live 100 years and wear a crown.
She really believes the fortune. But since you're being so generous, you can tell mine.
The sand tells a strange story. You shall dig ditches.
From Ferdinand de Lesseps, the great diplomat, France expects ditches.
Well, since you're laughing so hard, let's hear yours.
Well, if I knew Louis Napoleon's future, I'd know mine.
Well, that's a very interesting idea. We'd like you to tell us Louis Napoleon's future.
Very good idea.
Only if he himself is here.
Oh. Well, let me try. Here, let me try. Error. I see a throne. An imperial throne. Who's this approaching? Why, it's Louis Napoleon. In one hand, he carries the tricolor of the Republic.
Where's the other? Oh.
He walks forward. Mm-hmm. Looks at the throne. Mm-hmm. Looks at the tricolor. Mm-hmm. Puts it behind his back. And he walks toward the throne. He starts up the stairs. That's hard going. He keeps tripping on the tricolor.
Very amusing. May I?
Ferdinand, this is our dance. No, you want to make it worse.
The young man is a wit. A pity to waste him on Paris, where we have so many wits.
Oh, that's nice.
I designed it especially for Mademoiselle.
Oh, it's lovely.
It is beautiful, Mademoiselle. Ravissant. If Mademoiselle will permit, I shall name it the Eugène.
Oh, that's very nice of him. Thank you.
No, mademoiselle, no.
Oh, you don't. Well, yes, I suppose you're right. Monsieur le Marquis, you break is your mademoiselle.
Ray?
Oh. Yes, of course, I'll see him at once.
Yeah,
monsieur le Marquis?
Mademoiselle. Pardon me for calling this hour, but Monsieur le President desires an early answer.
Will you please tell Monsieur le President I should love to?
Mademoiselle.
Monsieur le Marquis. Oh, au revoir,
monsieur. Merci mille fois, mademoiselle, au plaisir.
Oh, thank you very much. The hat's a creation.
Sorry. Eugène.
Ferdinand.
Oh, Eugène, darling. I'm leaving to Egypt in an hour and 45 minutes. Will you marry me?
What?
I'm going there as secretary to the consulate. Marry me. Come with me. Renee's gone for the license.
What license? What are you talking about?
The marriage license. Pack things. We just trying to get to the church.
Oh, but I couldn't possibly do a thing like that. You know.
I don't need to understand. I may be gone a year, 5 years. This may be our last chance.
Oh, Ferdinand, are you insane?
No.
Yes.
Don't you see? It just isn't possible.
Yes, I see. I made an idiot of myself as usual. Asking you to change your whole life. Marry nobody and go live in a desert.
No, but you're not a nobody. You never could be. Never. It's... Well, it's just such a leap in the dark, and I... Well, darling, you must understand. You've got to. You do, don't you?
Yes, sir. I understand.
Oh, I wish I could go with you.
No, I won't ask you again. It wouldn't be fair. But please remember this. Whether I'm here or in Egypt...
Oh, I'm sorry.
Thanks, just the same.
The new gown is ready, mademoiselle. Oh, take it away. I don't want to see it.
Take it away, mademoiselle.
Yes, yes, surely, please.
Stop.
Cut your heart out.
I beg your pardon?
Oh, I was talking to Hassan.
Hassan?
Yes, my donkey. But you do.
At your service, mademoiselle.
Make him bring back my little house. My clothes, I need.
Well, why don't you come out and get them yourself?
Shame on you.
My dear young lady, I don't mind seeing you in your bathing dress. Oh. Shame on you.
It's none of your business. Go away.
Good afternoon, mademoiselle.
Oh, no. No, monsieur, please, no. I didn't mean it. Oh, please, monsieur, make him bring it back.
Come on, Hassan, mustn't keep the lady waiting.
Oh, no, no, no. Don't you know anything about donkeys? Make believe you want him to go forward.
Go forward? Mm-hmm. Forward, Hassan. On to victory. Come on. Oh. That's right. That's the way. Come on. Oh. Oh. That's good.
Good. Now, look the other way. I'll be dressed in a minute. What's your name?
The Lizettes.
Oh, you're the son. We've been expecting you.
We?
Yes, all the French people here. We heard you were very good looking, and you are.
What's your name?
Marie-Antoinette Germaine Pierre-Antoine Lecteur.
I'm very happy to know you, mademoiselle. Occupation?
Young lady.
Oh, young lady of leisure. Married?
No, but I could have been. Many times. Everybody wants to marry. Are you married?
No.
Good.
I'm glad somebody's happy about it.
Then, now, help me down.
This way, Fendi.
Ah, here we are. How are you, sir?
My boy.
I'd have come to meet you myself, but I had some business with the Viceroy that couldn't wait. But what's happened to you?
Well, I had a slight adventure.
Let me present my son, Sir Malcolm Cameron, Her Britannic Majesty's Consul General.
Oh, don't get upset.
How are you?
Well, I hope you'll pardon my appearance, but I seem to have fallen into the Mediterranean.
Don't tell me that Louis Napoleon so pressed for money that he makes his diplomats swim to their boats.
No, but we Frenchmen must do our swimming in the Mediterranean while we still have the chance.
Huh?
Before it becomes a British pond.
Young man, you'll bear watching.
Well, here's to a long stay and a successful one. Well, a successful one anyways. Thank you.
Well, I must be off. Thanks for the drink, Matthew. I'll see you at the Viceroy's reception tonight. It's been a pleasure to meet you, young man.
Thank you, Sir Malcolm. So that's Sir Malcolm Cameron, eh?
Yes, do you know about him?
Only what everyone in the Foreign Office knows. That when England sent him to watch the kettle, it means something important is brewing.
Right you are. We must do our best to upset it. Well, come get out of these reds before you take gold. A diplomat with a sore throat is about as useful as a fiddle without strings.
And I do what must deliver.
Holly! Holly! Where are you?
Where have you been?
Running off without telling me. Bad discipline. If the army about me.
Yes, my father.
Don't grandfather me. I'm ranking sergeant of the consul in detail, and I expect obedience.
Yes, Baron.
Look at this. Grey as a goose. I spent all afternoon hunting for the hair dye.
I hate it, grandfather. I was afraid what the name might see.
Mm-hmm. Oh, Lord, yeah, get it. What must the army think of us? Where have you been?
Swimming with Monsieur de Lesseps.
What?
No, no, grandfather. With his son, the young one.
Huh?
Oh, he's so funny. So polite. Oh, I think I'll fall in love with him.
What? The Consul General's son? I forbid that you understand. This is an order.
Yes, grandfather.
Yes, who?
Yes, sergeant.
Sir Malcolm, delighted to see you.
Your Highness, another evening to charm the memory and ruin the figure.
Matthew.
Malcolm.
Come on. Alan Vassalan Yasafiki.
Alan Vassalan Galalitin Kidi.
The presence of my good friend honors my heart.
It is my great pleasure, Your Highness, to present my son.
It is my great pleasure to welcome to my court another of your illustrious family. Thank you. Who is that?
That is Prince Said, the next Viceroy of Egypt, and your first assignment.
am I supposed to do with him?
Cultivate him. Make a friend of him.
Okay.
So, here you are. Trying to catch a glimpse of a young gentleman, eh? Come now. Get along with you. Do your marketing.
Yes, grandfather.
What?
The saddle.
His Highness, Prince Said is calling to see Monsieur Ferdinand de Lucet.
I got him.
Oh, don't go, grandfather. I don't
care. Attention!
Mais non, vous ne pouvez pas y rentrer, monsieur. Très
heureux. Oh, fiche-moi la
paix. Oh, je regrette, monsieur ne veut pas déranger.
Très bien.
Oh, mademoiselle, je vous en prie. Oh, vous en prie, je rentre.
Hello?
How about yourself? What are you doing here?
I just dropped in.
So I see. But you're coming on very busy.
Who is she?
A friend of mine.
I suppose you're in love with her. Mm-hmm. She doesn't look like much.
Now look here, Tony. I've got a lot of very dull work to do, and my mind is not. And it's hot. I wish to heaven I were back in Paris, and the flies are driving me mad. And now you have to come in and make matters worse.
All right. I just came to tell you that he's here.
Who?
You know, the prince.
Said? You mean to say that you've left him waiting up?
I only wanted to talk to you. Oh, you're not like
her, will you? I gotta take you over my knee and smack you.
Oh, why don't you? Go.
Good afternoon, Matthew.
Good afternoon, Margot.
I was hoping you'd join me.
Thank you. What are you doing?
Brushing up on your tricks? Maybe I'll need them. Now that I have two of you to fight.
Only one, I'm sorry to say. I'm going back to Paris.
Paris?
Yes, I've just had a letter from Victor Hugo. Things look pretty bad.
Oh, I shall miss you, Matthew. There's no fun bowling at an empty wicket, you know.
Don't be too sure about that. I'm leaving my son in charge here.
Oh, that, eh?
Yeah, I haven't told him yet. Poor fellow, I'm afraid it'll be a blow to him.
What's that?
Okay. Right, assemble. Okay. One, two, three, four. Very careful. Okay. Move your guard a little more to the left. Very careful. Ready? Good boy, Your Highness.
I get rid of the old fox. And he leaves me with a young one.
My father's carriage for a few hours.
Of course you must, but remember you promised to ride all the way to Suez.
Oh, all right, I will ride.
Good boy, Said.
Yes, I know, but I was worried about you.
About me? What do you mean?
Look. See? Grey as a ghost. Without me to fix it, they'll be calling you Old Man Terror.
You ready, Sai?
My friend, I cannot ride with you today. This morning, the boxing, yesterday, 8 hours in the saddle.
All right. You've earned a day on your back.
Thank you.
There.
This camp is no place for a young woman.
Yes.
Send you home tomorrow. It's no discipline.
Yes.
Well, what are you doing here?
I followed you all the way from Alexandria. Are you glad I came? Oh, look. Let's race the storm to ruins.
Considered the most beautiful woman in Europe.
She's not. You think so because you're in love with her? Oh, I hope
her. Come on, Tony, sit up. Sit up.
I'm sorry. Couldn't help it. It always happens.
What do you mean?
When a woman falls in love with a man.
Listen to me. You mind if I give you a little friendly advice?
No.
Well, forget all about this falling in love business.
Oh, but I don't want to forget it. Don't you like me?
When the storm's passed.
Oh. Look, a rainbow. Grandfather says there's a pot of gold at the end.
One end in the Mediterranean and the other in the Red Sea. What a pot of gold for the world if they could be joined. The Red Sea and the Mediterranean. Look, Tony. The water in the old Gulf. Just as it was centuries ago when the Phoenicians sailed through. Can you imagine ships sailing right through here where we're standing?
Ships?
Yes, not ancient galleys, but modern ships. Steamers sailing a short trade route to the east. It could be done. There's no elevations, no rock formations. Just a simple sand ditch. And I was told I was going to dig ditches. There's fate in this, Tony. Something sent me here to Egypt when I didn't want to come and kept me here when I wanted to leave. I thought it was a dead end. It has been up to now. But I could make this spot that we're standing on the crossroads of the earth. Well, think of it, Tony. A canal stretching through from the Mediterranean. Open to the ships of all nations. It could be done. And I can do it. I was looking for a way to serve France. And I think I found a way to serve the world. My Highness has formed a stock company in Paris to finance the construction of the canal. But before I can go ahead, I must have your Highness's assurance that Egypt will lease to us the necessary strip of territory.
I regret that I cannot give you that assurance.
What can your Highness lose? We take all the risk.
You are young, my friend. The wisdom of age will teach you the folly of tempering with the work of Allah.
What man can accomplish is also the work of Allah, since we are his creatures obeying his wishes.
Unfortunately, one must also consider the wishes of the Turkish government.
Does this objection come from Constantinople or from London?
From London?
You mean your government would oppose the construction of the canal?
I do.
But why? Can't they see that England would be the first to benefit by a canal through the isthmus? Think how it would shorten the sailing time to India, to England's possessions in the east.
No, no. But my government wants no short pathway to the east, with Louis Napoleon sitting on the gate.
Oh, but it's absurd to think that any one nation would dominate the canal. It would be open to the world. Your Highness, if you allow these selfish political considerations to sway you, Egypt, not France, will be the greater loser.
I'm sorry. I'd like to help you, but my hands are tied.
Secretary. Since when?
From no one.
Look, Tony, can't you find someplace else to play? I'm not in a very good humor.
Oh, good humor, bad humor. You must have a secretary to help you.
and take those books on the trade route to the ancient Phoenicians back to the library.
Which books?
The trade route to the ancient Phoenicians. What's the matter? Can't you read? Didn't you go to school?
Oh, yes.
For how long?
About 2 days. It was so dull. I ran away.
His Highness Prince Said.
I'm sorry, my friend. If I were the Viceroy... Yes. Thanks, Said. Tony, does this sun out here in Egypt ever do strange things to people?
Well, sometimes it makes them see things.
Yeah, that explains it. I must have been having hallucinations. Illusions of grandeur, thinking that I could change the map of the world.
Who knows, my friend? Inshallah.
And I thought I was going to Paris with you to be your secretary.
A secretary who can't even read?
Oh, I could go to school in Paris for a few days and learn to read. And then I could be your secretary.
Well, we won't have to worry about that now. Because we won't be going to Paris.
His Highness the Viceroy.
This is a great honor, Your Highness. Won't you come in?
I've been thinking about your project, monsieur, and the advantages it would bring to Egypt.
Yes, Your Highness.
As you know, I cannot officially give you permission to proceed, but I owe you much. I repeat, I cannot officially give you permission, but if you wish to go ahead with your preparations, you have my personal promise that when the time comes, my son and I will do our utmost to find a way to help you. May Allah bless you, my boy.
Talleyrand.
Yes.
Sergeant, you have your orders. Take Tony to the boarding school and report to my father's office.
Yes.
I suppose I couldn't start school tomorrow.
You start today.
But you will come to see me.
Of course I will.
No, I won't leave you. Leave you.
No, not Tony, no. Sergeant, don't just stand there. Do something.
Attention, Tony, attention. Qu'est-ce que tu fais?
Thank you. You better take her away before she causes a riot.
I hope I'm not interrupting anything.
The maid. Good to see you. No, that's just Tony. He's the old sergeant's granddaughter and a perpetual nuisance.
Oh, no.
In a way, that little pony was the inspiration for the greatest project ever conceived by the mind of man.
Oh, I suppose I'm in for one of your operations.
Eugene, did you give him my message?
Well, no. You see, I couldn't. The dispatch was rather late in arriving, and when I called on her, she was out.
Oh.
Fire away, my friend. I'm all ears for news of this canal.
Well,
sacre nom de Pierre.
All I need to start operations is the necessary money.
Nice. How do you expect to raise it?
Similar. Bank of France will loan to raise part of it, and the rest will be raised by the sale of shares to the public. In fact, you'll be one of the first buyers.
Oh, me? Oh, no. I'm just a poor politician.
I've been told there's no such thing as a poor politician.
Well, that's the first time in my life I've ever known a fortune teller to be right. And you would try and dig the biggest ditch in all history. I'm afraid Eugenie also takes her fortune teller seriously.
He said she'd wear a crown. Remarkable fellow, that fortune teller.
The waters of the Red Sea are 30 feet higher than those of the Mediterranean. If a canal were cut across the isthmus, it would cause the waters of the Red Sea to flow into the Mediterranean, flooding every port in southern Europe. That is the opinion of my engineering experts.
Oh, but that's absurd. Any schoolboy knows that open seas the world over seek the same level.
Are you an engineer?
No, but I claim enough elementary physics and common sense to know that the Red Sea couldn't flood the Mediterranean.
I'm afraid you've allowed your enthusiasm to flood your sense of discretion. I'm sorry, I must accept the verdict of my engineers. I'm inclined to agree with our excitable young friend. But we have more important things before us.
Why haven't you been to see me?
Would I have been welcome?
Oh, but of course. Old friends are always welcome.
Then you
do consider me a friend.
I've been worried about you, wondering what you thought. I want to explain.
Is it necessary for old friends to explain?
Do come soon. I want to hear about all you did in Egypt and the canal, what progress you're making.
Why don't you ask your friend Louis Napoleon about that? I'm sorry, Eugene. Countess?
Yes, yes, I am.
Rioting has broken out all over the city.
Rioting?
Yes, yes, the Marquis du Grey is waiting. Louis Napoleon wants you at the palace immediately.
Yes, of course, I'll come at once.
Hurry.
Ah, Victor. I think you know everybody. Oh, this is my son, Monsieur Victor Hugo. Monsieur? It's 1848 all over again. Violence breaking out all over the city.
I repeat, monsieur, our duty as members of the assembly is to stand fast.
It is my firm belief that Louis Napoleon is deliberately provoking all this disorder to give him an excuse for demanding the adjournment of the assembly.
Don't let's forget that Napoleon's argument all along has been that the assembly's refusal to adjourn is responsible for this riot.
You excuse me, monsieur. I have some work to do.
Poor boy has had a cruel disappointment. I hope he doesn't take it too hard.
La Comtesse de Montillon is here, monsieur.
I had to come. I need your help.
My help?
Yes. Louis feels that you can break this terrible deadlock in the assembly.
Oh, I see. I'm sorry, Eugenie. If there's a crisis, Napoleon has only himself to blame.
Oh, but it's all so ridiculous. Louis doesn't want the throne. All he wants is a strong, orderly government.
What do you think those people out there are shouting for? Monsieur Bonaparte the president or Louis Napoleon the emperor?
But Ferdinand, he's not responsible for every crackpot in Paris. Please listen to me. I know you dislike him, and I don't blame you.
My dislike is political, not personal.
But we must forget even our political differences. Ferdinand, come here. Look at this. It's going on all over France. Riots, bloodshed. There may even be a civil war. Oh, don't you see? It's for the good of France. That's all Louis is thinking of, believe.
Yes, but Eugenie, I wouldn't know what to do even if I wanted to help. I have no political influence.
No, but your father has. Convince him that the assembly should adjourn. Then when order has been restored, Louis promises to reconvene it without taking away any of its power.
My father wouldn't hear of it. I know how he feels about Napoleon. He doesn't trust him.
Even with his written promise that he means what he says? And if even with this you feel you can't trust him, you know you can trust me.
Monsieur, your attention please. I bring you an offer of compromise direct from Napoleon.
And what is his offer?
First, he asks that the assembly adjourn at once.
Impossible.
But he gives his solemn promise to reconvene it as soon as the rioting has been stopped.
But don't you realize what he's asking? That we throw away our one weapon, our strength of numbers. He'd never dare invade the assembly to arrest us. But separated, disbanded, we'd be helpless, an easy prey, at the mercy of any charge he might trump up against us.
But Monsieur de Lesseps, his promise, he's given his word.
The word of a Bonaparte.
The Bonapartes, whatever their ambitions, have always been men of honor.
But have we the right to gamble our liberties on the promise of one man?
And not the scratch of a pen to hold him to it?
On the contrary, sir. Oh, Father, there's so much at stake. The peace of France, maybe the future of all of us. Well, when I was coming here just now, I saw rioting, bloodshed in the streets, Frenchmen lifting their hands against each other. No one questions your patriotism, sir. But I love France, too.
then believe me, you can best serve your country and liberty by doing what Napoleon asks.
Well, monsieur, what do you say?
I think we should bring this before the assembly at once.
And suppose they refuse to listen to us?
They'll listen to you, sir.
The assembly is adjourned.
I expect you to have every important member of the opposition behind bars before morning. Except, of course, young Monsieur de Lesseps. He will find that his emperor is grateful. Gentlemen, you have your instructions.
Louis, you promised me. You told me I could promise him. What have you made me do?
Something for France that I couldn't do myself.
Oh, but they'll blame him. They'll call him a traitor.
I'm sorry, of course. But it will be only a temporary unpleasantness. And he shall have his reward. I intend to give his canal project my full support.
Oh, no, Louis, you don't understand. His family and his honor, they mean so much to him.
In a crisis, the individual is unimportant. The state is everything. The state. France, floundering in the fallacy of democracy. Its industries idle. Its army weak, crippled by the poisonous doctrines of the Republicans and the Socialists, has called me to save it from anarchy and ruin. I had to act swiftly, ruthlessly, but act. If I used young Derisets badly, it was for a great end.
You use me too, Louis. What can I possibly say to him? What would he think?
The opinion of one man should be a matter of little concern to the future Empress of France.
I'm sorry, Vicomte. You're under arrest.
Arrest?
By whose order? By order of the Emperor.
Emperor? Why, in the face of this?
Well, thank you, Vicomte. I've been looking for that.
But look here, Debray. Napoleon promised me...
Have no fear, de Lesseps. Napoleon keeps his promises. He's most grateful.
Grateful?
I don't know what he's talking about.
So, that's what it was. I see. Your canal.
Oh, look here, René. You don't believe that I...
Back here, I'm ready.
René! 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 René!
Your father will be proud of you for this.
Where's my father?
In his room, monsieur.
Sir Malcolm.
Stroke, sir.
Sir Malcolm, you were my father's best friend. You must believe me.
Because I was his friend, I will spare you my opinion of yourself. A high price to pay for a ditch.
But no, mademoiselle. Monsieur de Lesseps cannot be disturbed at this hour of the night, especially after what has happened. Perhaps tomorrow.
But mademoiselle, mademoiselle.
Mountain.
I'm so sorry.
At least he died thinking it was a dream.
Oh, you mustn't. Sit down. It's late. Try to sleep.
Sleep?
I will tell Monsieur that you are here.
Yes, thank you. He won't see you. Oh, but he must. It's terribly important. No, I won't let you.
But why? Who are you?
His friend. The only one he has left. Oh, how could you do this to him? First you break his heart, and then you make everybody hate him. What kind of a woman are you? Oh, get out, go away, and get me away from him.
Fine.
And then, oh, don't listen to her. No. No.
I didn't know. I swear I didn't. Louis promised me, and then he broke his promise. You do believe me, don't you?
Yes, I believe you. If it makes any difference.
Oh, but it does, of course it does. I have a message for you. He wants to make amends.
Amends? Can you bring my father back to life? Will he tell Paris the truth and clear our name?
Oh, but he can't. You see,
yes, it might show the savior of France in a rather bad light.
Now, will you go?
Please. Ferdinand, there's one thing we can do.
There's nothing anyone can do.
Have you forgotten your dream? The canal?
What about it?
Louis has promised me to withdraw his objections. He'll do anything you want.
And suppose I accept. Then everyone in Paris will be convinced that what they're already whispering is true. That I sold my party, my friends, and my father's life for a ditch. Tomorrow they'll hear the truth if I have to spend the rest of my life in prison.
Oh, what do you care what they think or what they say, as long as you know you did nothing dishonorable?
I never want to hear that ditch again as long as I live.
You're very fond of him, aren't you? Well, so am I. And perhaps I know him a little bit better than you. He's a dreamer and a creator. He was put on earth to do great things. Oh, this mustn't stop him. He owes it to the world and to himself to go through with his plans. Oh, my dear. He believes in you. Don't let him give up. You must make him realize that he's got to go on whatever the cost.
He never will. He's beaten.
Oh, no, no, you're wrong. There's something in him that'll never let him stop. It's a fire of greatness that isn't in you, Ernie. Oh, keep that light. You can do it. You got to do it.
To make people believe you, it means prison.
To be in prison these days is a guarantee of honor. But don't you understand? I can't go on forever having people think I'm a traitor, a Judas.
Oh, I know you're not. And you didn't have to tell me.
You're a stubborn little imp, aren't you?
It's because I believe in you.
This has just arrived by special messenger, monsieur.
Oh, it looks most important. I'm ready to pounce. I can read very well now. Play, play. Telegram?
Telegram.
Oh, yes. Telegram. From His Highness. Highness. Sahib Pasha. Oh, it's your friend.
Go on.
Viceroy.
Muhammad Ali is dead. Sahib is Viceroy of Egypt.
Really?
He wanted to know when I'm coming to start work on the canal.
Oh, you can begin at once. There is nothing to stop you now.
No, there's nothing to stop me now. But I can't do it.
So you can't do it. I thought you were going to do this wonderful thing for the world, a mistake. And the old viceroy trusted you. And Say trusted you. But you don't care anything about them anymore. Only about your honor and what people say. I know you are honorable, but I want you to be more than that. I want you to be great. And when the day comes, I want to stand beside you and see the ships go through the canal. I know you will lead for all the people in the world.
A little east of south till we reach the Bala Lakes. South Sen, most of the way.
Good. Send word to port side that we start digging tomorrow morning.
Laborers from Alexandria.
Oh, splendid. My compliments to Captain the Duke. And you see that housing for the men is prepared immediately.
Quiet.
Was captured by Arab raiders.
Arabs? Are we enough to carry on?
A little while, sir.
Order another ship from Marseille.
Yes?
We'll deal with the Arabs when the Viceroy arrives.
Yes.
Turkish soldier. Turkish? But the Sultan promises he wouldn't interfere. No, not openly. But there are ways of interfering. If there is trouble, you can count on me, my friend.
It's from Tony. You remember her, Your Highness.
Ah, yes, the little one.
lessons. Look how our handwriting's improved.
Now, don't go, Sergeant. You'll want to hear what's in here, too.
Yes, sir.
I miss you very much. I hope you miss me, too. The Emperor and Eugenie were married last week. All we girls in the school went and stood outside the church. She looked very beautiful, and the crowd cheered. I cheered, too. I was so glad she was married. Give my love to you. She sends your highness her love.
Oh, thank you.
Tell grandfather that I am sending him a bottle of hair tonic, Sergeant. They pardoned all the political prisoners to celebrate the wedding, including your friend Latour. So I celebrated too. I ran away from school, and now I'm his secretary.
That little rascal.
He writes things against the Emperor, and we have him printed secretly.
I have sent for her at once, sir.
No, there's no place for her here. She's in good hands with Renee. First thing he knows, she'll be writing his pamphlets for him.
She's very fierce, the little one,
huh? Yes, takes after her grandmother.
Needs England's friendship, and England will not stand for the canal.
But it's Ferdinand's. He's building the canal. Even Napoleon cannot stop him.
You forget that he's an emperor. With one stroke of the pen, he can cut off every sou of the canal's financial backing.
But he's been working all this time. They must let him finish it. They cannot do this. I won't let them.
I'm afraid there's very little that you or I or anyone else can do when Prussia rattles the sabre.
Your Majesty, the Suez Canal is far too important to France and to the world to be used as just a political pawn. I urge upon you most earnestly to reconsider your action and let me finish this great project.
And embark upon a war with Prussia without the support or at least the neutrality of England?
Why is there any need for war if your Majesty sincerely desires peace?
Peace without honor? Can I disregard my destiny? The motto of the Bonapartes is still glory for France. I'm sorry, I can give you no more time. Gentlemen.
You see, week after week to watch ambition undermine, destroy his balance and his judgment. Wants war, glory, that's all he thinks of now. Learn where to land, and finish the end.
What will you do if he...
If he loses, and the empire falls, I stay with him, of course. He'll leave me there. You see, Ferdinand, once I made a choice. Maybe it was a mistake, but it was my choice.
And you've made my problem yours.
I failed. Yes, Ferdinand, I failed, but you won't. You'll win. Not through Louis' help or mine, but through your own efforts. I don't know how, but somehow you'll do it.
You have so much faith in me.
Well, I've never lost it. And I never will.
Always what I need. I almost didn't know you.
Is that a compliment?
You're lovely.
That's the first time you ever told me. Oh, I bought a plane of yours.
So you see, I found my niche in the pamphleteer for democracy.
True, why?
I haven't as great a reading public as Rousseau had, but I managed. And Tony has been a tremendous help.
Except with the spelling.
You know, she edits everything I write.
If I didn't, you'd go back to prison.
But from now on, we're going to be together, the three of us, hmm?
Where you go, we'll go.
I'm leaving for England tomorrow. England, well, don't you think first a long rest?
Rest. You are going to stay right here, and let Tony and me take care of you.
The only thing that stands in my way now is the English government. My one chance is to go there before it's too late. Explain it to them. Break down their opposition. Now, I must go there at once and try to see the Prime Minister.
I'm sorry, Mr. de Lesseps. I cannot support a project that is clearly opposed to the best interests of England.
But I assure you it will be of the greatest benefit to England. Many of your own countrymen are convinced of this. Men of vision who can see beyond mere national boundaries.
I disagree with you, sir, completely. In fact, at this very time, we are debating in Parliament this insane policy of reckless expansion for England. Englishmen should keep their eyes on their own boundaries, not gaze moonstruck on foreign shores and fly-by-night foreign schemes like yours. I'm sorry, Mr. de Lesseps. I bid you good afternoon, sir.
Conduct of our colonial policy has been criticized by those who would place the welfare and safety of our colonies above the welfare and safety of England. They would risk their heads to save the limbs. Our first duty is to the mother country, England. Yeah. I would not trade the meanest English county for all our colonial possessions. Yeah. The path of headlong expansion is the path to disaster.
Mr. Speaker, sir, you have just heard the Prime Minister most ably and eloquently urge your support of the government's colonial policy. To his noble bellow, I wish to add my own small voice. The Prime Minister has not always enjoyed my support, no. In fact, there have been times when I've been forced to take issue with him.
Who is that?
It's the leader of the opposition, Mr. Disraeli. But now, strangely enough, I find myself pleading his cause.
What's he up to?
Some trickery, I'll wager.
By all means, support this policy. By all means, rally round the Prime Minister. By all means, follow cheerfully and unquestioningly his leadership. All of you who are as anxious as he to see England reduced to the standing of a third-rate power.
Courage, courage!
I must speak to you. It's very important.
And who are you?
Ferdinand de Lesseps.
Break it down.
The greatest danger is in delay. I had a message this morning from Saeed Pasha, the viceroy. The desert works fast. Unless we can get our dredges going in the next few months, all the years of work, all the millions that we've spent, will be a total loss to us, to say nothing of a far greater loss to the world.
Why have you come to me?
Because England needs the Suez Canal. Because soon you're going to have a general election. But above all, because you represent progressive and intelligent English opinion.
I'm thinking what my enemies will say. Dizzy the internationalist. Dizzy the poseur. Dizzy the foreigners, they say, conspiring with a Frenchman in some evil-smelling foreign plot to undermine British institutions.
Then you will do it?
Of course I'll do it. You've brought me a whiff of hope, monsieur. Frankly, my party's been the underdog in this election. We haven't expected to get a majority in the House. But I feel you've given me an issue here which dramatizes my whole stand, strikes at the very heart of the government's do-nothing, thumb-twiddling policy. They see an England that stretches only from Land's End to John O'Groats, from Wales to Norfolk, a tiny island off the coast of France. I see an England flung around the globe. And you, a Frenchman, are doing the work Englishmen should be doing to help create this greater England. Monsieur, if you're willing to take a supporting chance, go back to Egypt, keep up your work, at least try and save what you've already done. Raise the money somehow. I give you my solemn promise that if my party's returned at this election, I'll do everything in my power to place England on your side. Come, let's have some supper.
Formidable piastres, Uranus.
Uranus?
Isn't he the Comte Ruby?
Yes. He was given my father by the Sultan for defeating the Wahhabi in the Arabian campaign.
But isn't it enough for you to empty your treasury? I know how much these heirlooms mean to you. I wish you wouldn't sign.
Oh, no, my friend. Have you forgotten that sand is filling the canal? The banks falling in? Machinery rusting? See, this body is stone. Yet with it, I can buy a great future for my country. You'll beat Zependia.
42? 43? Capo! Four games in a row. You're too easy.
No, you're too good. Rene, Come take my place. Give her a good beating.
With pleasure.
There's something on your mind?
Yes. We can't hold out much longer. Even this way. Not making any actual progress, but just keeping what we've already got. Fighting back to death. And I don't know whether I could even have done that without my guide, philosopher, and friend.
Have I been a good secretary?
You've been a good angel. But I've been worried about you, Tony.
Me?
Yes. I've been so selfish. Letting you come down here.
Oh, but I wanted to.
Yes, I know. But you should be thinking about your own life, your future, your best years are before you, marriage, children, all the things that belong to a happy, normal life. Not tying yourself down to a lunatic with a visionary idea. Tony.
It's all right. Maybe I'd rather be lunatic with you. Even if you don't want me in other way.
Tony, listen to me.
Oh, you have enough troubles without needing one, too. Let's forget about it.
Hmm? Oh, it's quiet, isn't it? Unnaturally quiet. It's as if the whole world were standing still, listening, waiting for something to happen. Look, Ibis is from the Nile. I don't believe I've ever seen them so far from home.
I have. Years ago in Alexandria, the year of the devil wing. Listen.
What's the matter with you? Those are only the jackals. Come on.
What's up?
Get it over! Sabah the wheel! Wallahi, my shift is I have a good look to me.
Rene, go get the arms. This is the best chance. Sergeant, we're not in the cabin. Get them in out. Get ropes, brace the dress.
Yes.
Come on, Tony, we'll get the women to a place to stay. Get the women out. Take them into the food cells.
Thank you.
was in the line of duty, sir.
Port towns easily. But I'm afraid when the returns from Nottingham and Birmingham come in.
Yes, I'm afraid you're right. Apparently, the present government have temporarily averted the danger of England taking over the leadership of the world. Well, it's no use crying. There'll be other elections. I'm sorry for that poor Frenchman. I hear he's bankrupted himself, as well as the Viceroy of Egypt. Can't be honest to win. Oh, send Peterson to me, will you? I want him to file a telegram.
Yes, Mr. Duvall.
Good evening.
Mr. Disraeli, I have the honor to inform you that Her Majesty the Queen extends her congratulations on your party's victory in the election. May I add my own congratulations, sir?
Thank you, Lord Benson. Would you inform Her Majesty that the first thing I shall do is to put her into business as senior partner in the firm of Victoria de Lesseps and Company. We are building a shorter route to Her Majesty's Eastern Empire.
I want to stand beside you and see the ships go through the canal and know you believed for all the people in the world.